Today, we're diving into a hot topic that's causing quite a stir. You may have seen the headlines suggesting that Listerine mouthwash could cause cancer. But before you toss that bottle in the trash, let's break down what's really going on. Listerine has been a household name for over a century. Named after Joseph Lister, it started as a disinfectant and cleaning agent before becoming the top dentist-recommended mouthwash we know today. But recently, some researchers have raised serious concerns about its safety. We all want to maintain good oral hygiene, and many of us reach for mouthwash to keep our breath fresh and our mouths clean. So when news breaks that a common product like Listerine might be dangerous, it's definitely alarming. So what's the deal with the Listerine causes cancer claim? The buzz started with a study in Germany where researchers looked at whether mouthwash use could impact the incidence of STIs in gay men. Over 3 months, participants used Listerine Cool Mint daily and then switched to a placebo rinse for another 3 months. The study found high concentrations of two bacteria in the participants' mouths, Fusobacterium nucleatum and Streptococcus aeruginosus, both linked to cancers like oral and colorectal. The researchers noted that Listerine use was associated with an increased abundance of these bacteria, which are also found in periodontal diseases and systemic illnesses. However, this doesn't mean Listerine directly causes cancer. The study's findings are not conclusive and need further scrutiny. Some experts suggest that the ethanol in Listerine, which is around 20% alcohol, might not be enough to kill all bacteria. Listerine responded to these claims, pointing out that the study lacked important design controls and had a small sample size. They emphasized that more rigorous research is needed before drawing any conclusions. Plus, if you're concerned, Listerine already offers alcohol-free options. It's also worth considering other factors like dietary habits, smoking, alcohol consumption, and overall hygiene, which can all contribute to oral cancer. The study didn't account for these variables, making it hard to pinpoint Listerine as the culprit. So, should you throw away your Listerine? Probably not just yet. While the link between alcohol-based mouthwashes and cancer needs more research, it's too early to panic. Talk to your healthcare provider about your oral care routine, and if you're still worried, consider switching to an alcohol-free mouthwash. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon for more health updates. Drop a comment below if you have any questions or topics you'd like us to cover next.